Somebody say, we need a move.
We need a move.
Hallelujah. We need a move. Amen. How everybody doing today? Amen.
All right.
Can y'all hear me? Somebody give me a thumbs up if you can hear me. Hallelujah. We need a move, Father. We need a move from you, God. Father, as you decrease, as we decrease, you increase in us, Father. We need a move. Somebody give me a thumbs up if you can hear me. We need a move. We need a move, God. Hallelujah. We need a move. We need a move. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody gonna give me a thumbs up? You can hear me. Thank you, Jesus. All right. Okay. Hallelujah. Amen. Get your Bibles. Amen. I want everyone to follow me in the word on today. Amen. So very important that you will follow me. The Lord gave me this word. Amen. And it was personal. Amen. Personal. Amen. Go with me to Joshua, the 7th chapter. Joshua, the 7th chapter. We're going to start at the first verse. We're going to basically do the whole chapter. But I want you to know that the Lord has equipped every saint with what they need for the journey. The Word of God states He's given us everything pertaining to life and godliness. He gave us everything we needed to excel, to be effective, to move forward. It's already in you. You have to exercise that's already in you. And He told us righteousness exalts a nation. Sin brings a reproach on any people. All of us, in some form or another, He done put us in a leadership role. Whether you're a leader in your home, whether you're a leader on the job, whether you're a leader in the community, whether you're a leader in the family, all of us have been tasked with being a leader in some form or another. And so He wants us to showcase His glory. He said if we abide in Him and His word abide in us, then we can ask what we will and He'll give it to us. And He said, if we just listen to Him, many that are led by the Spirit of God, them He gave power to become the sons of God. Joshua, the 7th chapter, the first verse, it says, but the children of Israel committed a trespass in the accused thing for Achan, the son of Carmi, the son of Zebediah, and the son of Zerah, of the tribe of Judah, took of the accused thing, and the anger of the Lord was kindled against the children of Israel. The first thing I want you to see, people of God, as a leader, whatever task God give you, you are fully responsible for whatever happened on your watch. He charged you with that.
Amen.
And so we have to be not only responsible, we have to learn to be mature and be obedient in the things of God. First thing I want you to see, Achan was the one that committed the accused thing here. He was the one that sinned, but the Lord charged it to Israel. He said, I'm mad at Israel because they committed the accused thing. Sometimes because one person sinned, it would affect the whole body of Christ. It's almost like a cancer. If you don't cut it out, it'll spread and it'll become effective to the body of Christ. And so because Joshua was the leader, he was responsible for the tribe. And so it affected not only him, but the whole tribe. Righteousness exalts a nation, but sin brings a reproach on any people. And when you're the head of something, when he place you in charge of something, you are responsible for what's going on. A lot of times we don't want that responsibility because I'm one that don't like that kind of responsibility. But sometimes the Lord sees more in you than what you see in you.
Amen.
He has more faith in you sometimes than you have in you. And so he know that you the man for the job. I'm reminded of how he tasked Gideon. He gave Gideon some responsibility. Placed him in charge. And Gideon said, no, I don't want to do this. He said, I'm the least in my family. I don't want to do it. But the Lord said, you are the chosen one. Moses didn't want to do it. He said he had a speech problem. He had a speech impediment. But the Lord said, I've chose you. I equipped you. And so many times before he places us in leadership position, he already equipped us with what we need. Second verse says, and Joshua sent men from Jericho to Ai, which is besides Bahati, on the east side of Bethel, and spake unto them, saying, go up and view the country. And the men went up and viewed Ai. Joshua was here, was sending the tribe up to view their next challenge, to view the next war they was going to partake of. And Joshua, because of his relationship with Christ, he would always get the victory because his relationship, he knew how to pray. He knew how to wait on the instructions and the directions of the Father. When you accustomed to always being victorious because who you connected to, and all of a sudden, you're losing battles, and you know you hadn't done no wrong. You hadn't sinned. You've been doing what you usually do. All your ordinances, paying your tithes, giving offerings, being faithful, loving on God's people. And all of a sudden, you're in a position where you're taking a loss. He sent the people to view, to scout out the next assignment, the next battle. And it's saying, they returned to Joshua and said unto him, let not all the people go up, but let about 2,000 or 3,000 men go up and smite Ai, and make not all the people to labor thither, for they are but a few. In other words, they came back and told Joshua, you don't need to send a lot of people for this battle. We don't need but a few to overtake them because we know God is with us. And how many know when God be for you, He's more than the world against you.
Amen.
And so they instructed the leader here, we don't need a lot of people. We can take them out with a few because we have the favor of God on us. When you have favor on you, you don't have to do a lot of work.
Amen.
The Lord is doing the work. He needs you to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. And sometimes, people of God, you can get comfortable with the victory. You can get comfortable. You can become at ease in Zion because you're so used to being victorious because God is on your side. And it says, so they went up thither of the people, about 3,000 men, and they fled before the men of Ai. And the men of Ai smote of them about 36 men. But they chased them from before the gate even unto Shaverim, and smote them in the going down, wherefore the hearts of the people melted and became as water. In other words, where they thought they was going to get the victory, they thought this was just a battle like usual. They thought they was going to work like usual, and God was going to automatically give them the victory. But in this battle, they were defeated. They lost some people in battle. It was some casualties in this battle. They was accustomed to being victorious, but here they found themselves being defeated. And they became saddened. Their hearts melted because they felt like God let them down. They felt like they were let down. They just knew they was going to get the victory. And how many of you spent time in prayer, fasting, and always been victorious? God always gave you what you wanted. He always done what you wanted him to do. He answered you. He led you. A pillar of cloud by day and fire by night. He ordered your steps. Whenever you needed the victory, he was right there with you, instructing you every step of the way. But all of a sudden, things change. And you don't feel the same way you used to feel. All of a sudden, you're tasting defeat and don't know why. All you know is you hadn't done nothing wrong. You tried to keep his ordinance. You tried to stay faithful. You tried to be committed to the assignment. And so Joshua was here, didn't know what was going on. And it's bad when a leader don't know what's going on. He trusted the tribe and the tribe leaders to give him a report and tell him what was going on. Sometimes the people have to be your eyes and your ears because you can't be everywhere. And so Joshua just trusted. He thought this was going to be war as usual. We'll send a few men out, and we have come back victorious. But look what it says. And Joshua rent his clothes. He was upset. And he fell to the earth upon his face before the ark of the Lord until the evening tide. He fell to his face. He was so disgruntled. He was so upset. He was disgusted because he lost some men. Innocent men lost their life because they simply obeyed their leader that he sent out the war. He was taking responsibility for losing the battle, for losing his men in war. And so he rent his clothes and he got upset. All the way to the evening, he rested with sackcloth and ashes and humbled himself. And he and the elders of Israel, they put dust upon their head. And Joshua said, Elias, O Lord God, where hast thou at all brought this people over Jordan to deliver us into the hands of the Ammonites, to destroy us? Joshua is upset. And so he's petitioning the Lord, why did you bring us out here to lose this battle? You didn't have to bring us this far. You could have left us where we was at if we're going to be defeated. And sometimes you get upset. Sometimes you develop an attitude. You become deranged because you don't know why all of a sudden things change. You know you didn't do no different. You know you always served the Lord with all your heart, all your might. You know you've been faithful. You know you've been committed. You know you always laid before the Lord and got instructions. And so now you tasked with this defeat, feeling defeat, so you discouraged. Because now you got a feeling that you never had before. Somebody said righteousness exalts a nation. Mm-hmm. But sin brings a reproach on any people. All this happened because of one man's sin, Achan. Because he angered God, God removed his hands off the tribe. And I come to tell you, when you're a leader and there's sin in the camp, God will remove his hands. God will withdraw himself from you. He will cause you to experience things you never experienced before. He will cause some rain to fall in your life. He'll cause some dark clouds to rise up in your life. He'll cause defeat, you to feel the agony of defeat. And so here it is, he was upset. Joshua was upset. And he challenging the Lord, why did you bring us out here to be destroyed by the Ammonites? He said, would to go, we have been content and dealt on the other side of Jordan. We'd have been all right if you just left us on the other side of Jordan and wouldn't even led us up here to this battle. We'd have been fine if you just left us alone. These men would still be here. The ones that lost their life would still have their families. What's really going on? Have you ever stopped and asked yourself, what's really going on in your house? What's really going on in the church? What's really going on in the family? What's really going on? Sometimes we live our life so at ease that we don't even question nothing. We don't even petition God. We don't even look beyond the surface to see what's really going on. Why are we not tasting the victories that we used to taste? Why we don't feel the anointing like we used to feel? Why? The presence of the Lord is not brazen us no more. Why? Did you not know this God can withdraw himself from you? Just like Samson. When Samson told his secret, the Lord withdrew the anointing from him. He no longer had the strength he used to have. He no longer was in the position he used to be in. Mm-hmm. Whenever you go against God, there's consequences and repercussions. And so here it is, he was so upset. He said, you could have just left us on the other side of Jordan. He said, oh Lord, what shall I say when Israel turneth their back before their enemies? For the Canaanites and all the inhabitants of the land shall hear of this and shall environ us round and cut us off and cut off our name from the earth. And what wilt thou do unto thy great name? In other words, Lord, this is going to make you look bad. What they going to say when they hear about us losing this battle? What they going to say when they hear about us being defeated? What they going to say? You know that God, you've been looking good because God's anointing is on your life. You've been victorious because his anointing is on your life. You've been excelling in life only by the grace of God. And people can see, your enemy can see it. Your worst enemy know that the anointing is on your life. Can't nobody argue that because you've always been victorious. So Joshua here is saying, Lord, this make you look bad. We're representing you. They never seen us be defeated. They've always seen how you led us cloud by day and fire by night. You always led us and gave us instructions. What the people gonna say when they get wind of this? What all our other enemies gonna say? They're gonna be ready to challenge us because they see that we experience defeat. They gonna know, and let me put a pin here and tell you this. Folk know when the Holy Spirit done left you. Not only you know, your enemy know. We don't have that same covering over you. The enemy know when that shield have been pulled from you. The enemy know. And it don't look so tasting. It don't look so glamorous when you taste defeat. And so he was challenging God, how this gonna make you look? What you think the people gonna say? They know as you leading us. They know as you guiding us. They know as you protecting us. And now you done withdrew yourself. Every leader know when they done lost the anointing. Every leader know when the Holy Spirit done moved his hands from them. And Joshua wasn't no different. Mm-hmm. And the Lord said unto Joshua, get thee up, wherefore liest thou dust upon thy face? Get up from there. Ain't no need to complaining. You the leader, you need to find out what's really going on. Mm-hmm. So get up from the face. The Lord told him, Israel have sinned, and they have also trespassed my covenant, which I have commanded them, for they have even taken of the accused thing, and have also stolen and dissembled also. And they have put it even among their own stuff. Not only did they steal, but they put my stuff with their stuff. And here it is, the leader don't even know what happened. All he know is innocent people dying. All he know is the whole tribe is cursed behind one man action. That's why you have to check those that's in the house. We as leaders have to straighten out the sin in the church. Mm-hmm. You got to stand up to the wrongness in the home, mm-hmm. on the job, wherever God placed you to be a leader, we have to speak up.
Amen.
We cannot let justice go undone.
Amen.
We cannot let it go unserved. We have to speak up because we are held accountable because he resides in us. Mm-hmm. Great is he that is in you than he that is in the world. And innocent people will die. Innocent people become casualties behind one sin going unchecked. It's like a cancer. It's spreading throughout the body. No, you don't have to be the one that sinned. Because somebody sinned among you, remember, we all members, but we're in one body. And so we're responsible for what your brother and sister do. They mix their stuff with God's stuff. Not only did they sin, but they trespassed against the covenant. And they mix their stuff with my stuff. He said, therefore, the children of Israel could not stand before their enemies, but turned their backs before their enemies because they were accused. Neither will I be with you anymore, except you destroy this accused from among you. Mm-hmm. I'm lifting my hands from you. Until you deal with the sin, I got to withdraw my hands from you. Mm-hmm. It's a sad thing, my brothers and sisters, when God withdraw his hands from us because one person sinning. You got to cut out the cancer before it spread. When they find cancer in your body, the first thing they do is try to hurry up and do surgery to cut it out before it spread. We all members in one body. If you don't check it at the door, it'll become contagious. It'll spread like wildfire. It'll get out of control quickly. And innocent people will start dying. It'll run through generations after generations. That's why you can't turn a deaf ear to it. You can no longer turn your head to sin. Mm-hmm. It has to be addressed.
Yes.
It has to be confronted.
Yes.
Because it's killing too many innocent people.
Mm-hmm.
Here it is, he told Joshua, not only they mixed it among my stuff, but I caused them to lose the battle. Mm-hmm. And if you don't deal with it, I won't be with you no more. Mm-hmm. Look like it's unfair. Because Joshua never committed a sin. He've always stayed in the presence of the Lord. He gave his tithes. He was always faithful. But all of a sudden, he experiencing defeat. He experiencing a loss, great loss among his tribe. And the Lord here is telling him, if you don't deal with this accused thing, I'm going to remove my hands from you. I won't be with you no more. It's a great deal of responsibility that leaders have. That's why I'm understanding more and more now, we ain't in this thing to be liked. We're in this thing to be a servant to the Most High. We have to obey him at all costs. Because when you turn your head to certain things, we are protectors. We are gatekeepers. We're watchmen on the wall. And we have to check people that decide to come contaminate the body of Christ with their own lust demons and their own selfish ambitions.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody got to pay the price. And so here it is. He say, I'm going to give you some instruction. He say, sanctify the people and say, sanctify yourselves against tomorrow. But thus said the Lord God of Israel, there is an accused thing in the midst of thee. O Israel, thou canst not stand before thy enemies until you take away the accused things from among you. Let me put another pin here. You can't go on as business as usual. Sometimes you got to stop and address the issue because sin stagnates the body of Christ. It shuts the movement down. It brings it to a halt. There's no more victories. There's no more victories in the body of Christ until it's dealt with. So the church is at a standstill until we get this thing straight. That's why the Bible says when you find your brother or sister in a fault, those that are spiritual, go confront them. Considering yourself in that fault. The Bible says, as leaders, lay your gift down at the altar. Your gift means nothing to me until you can get this thing straight. Lay it down at the altar, and I need you to come together and get whatever the problem is straight before I put my hands back on that. See, we expect the Lord to do everything, but some things he placed in our hands to do. He gave us the responsibility on earth. We are his little gods on earth, and we have challenges that's facing us.
Mm-hmm.
Every last one of us. Going to be challenged with a task that we're going to be in charge of. Again, whether it's in your home, whether it's on your job, whether it's in the body of Christ, whether it's in the family, they can't go no further until sin is dealt with, until they realize that God is not pleased. And so he said, I'm not going to even let you stand before your enemies. He said, in the morning, there you shall be bought according to your tribe. And it shall be that the tribe which the Lord taketh shall come according to the families thereof. And the families which the Lord shall take shall come by households. And the household which the Lord shall take shall come man by man. In other words, I want you to set up Joshua, and I want every tribe and every family and every man to come before you. And I'm going to show you who done this thing. Bring them before you and ask them. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to show you who the guilty party is. Mm-hmm. People of God, at this point, the movement is shut down. You can't continue to walk past sin. I need you to stop and deal with this, as there'll be no more victories. You will have nothing but defeat in your life, because he done removed his hands. Mm-hmm. He done withdrew the anointing from the camp. And whenever the anointing has departed, you always find yourself on the side of defeat. And so he told him, I'm going to bring tribe by tribe before you. Man by man, family by family. And it shall be that he that is taken with the accused thing shall be burnt with fire. He and all he had, because he has transgressed the covenant of the Lord, and because he had wrought folly in Israel. Notice again, because of one man, the whole movement is shut down. Because of one man, the anointing has lifted. Because of one man, the whole tribe is suffering. People lost their life. And I come by to tell you, if you don't check what's going on in your house, if you don't check what's going on in your family, the movement will come to a halt. There's no more victories. It's nothing but defeat. We can no longer shout and dance past sin. We can no longer preach past it.
Amen.
It has to be dealt with. Mm-hmm. It has to be confronted. Head on.
Yes.
Because it's killing a body. Mm-hmm. It's causing innocent folk to suffer. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's easy to say, well, I'm not with that. I have nothing to do with that. Sometimes we want to live our life with just me, myself, and I don't bother nobody. I don't want nobody to bother me. But we are all members in one body. And we're all held accountable. Mm-hmm. We're all responsible, yes, for what go on in the body. Mm-hmm. This is why we have to speak out, because look what the Lord called it. He said they wrought folly. He called it folly. They irresponsible. They don't care about folk life. They don't care about the movement. They don't care about the anointing. And some folk got wrong motives in the house of God. They don't care about God's anointing. They don't care about being prosperous. They don't care about being victorious. They simply don't care. They just there for what they can get. But they have to be singled out, people of God. They have to be challenged and called out on this. And it says, so Joshua rose up early in the morning and brought Israel by their tribes. And the tribe of Judah was taken. And he bought the family of Judah, and he took the family of the Zeronites, and he bought the family of the Zeronites man by man, and Zebedee was taken, and he bought his household man by man, and Achan, the son of Carmi, the son of Zebedee, the son of Zerah, of the tribe of Judah was taken. And Joshua said unto Achan, my son, give, I pray thee, glory to the Lord God of Israel, and make confession unto him, and tell me now what thou hast done. Hide it not from me. And Achan answered Joshua and said, indeed, I have sinned against the Lord God of Israel. And thus have I done. Here it is, Achan say he done this sin. He sinned. And let me put another pin here for you that don't know. Achan was Joshua's right-hand man. It's kind of what we say an adjutant, an armor bearer. He was one of the closest men to Joshua. Joshua trusted him. But when you being led by the Spirit of God, you got to obey what the Lord say.
Mm-hmm.
And so Achan say, I done this. At least he was honest. He took responsibility. But by this time, you had casualties. You had blood on your hand. Innocent people lost their life. He said, I have done this. He said, when I saw among the spoils of the goodly Babylonish garment and 200 shekels of silver and a wedge of gold of 50 shekels weight, then I covered them and I took them, and behold, they are hidden in the earth in the midst of the tent and the silver under it. So Joshua sent messengers, and they ran into the tent, and behold, it was hid in his tent and the silver under it. And they took them out of the midst of the tent and brought them unto Joshua and unto all the children of Israel and laid them out before the Lord. Mm-hmm. And Joshua and all Israel with him took Achan and the son of Zorah, and the silver, and the garment, and the wedge of gold, and his sons, and his daughters, and his oxen, and his asses, and his sheep, and his tent, and all that he had, and they brought them unto the valley of Achor. And Joshua said, why hast thou troubled us? The Lord shall trouble thee this day. And all of Israel stoned him with stones and burnt them with fire. After they had stoned them with stones. Listen, I need you to get this, people of God, as I get ready to close. Achan committed the sin. But notice, it say they got stoned because of his sin. His wife, his children, his cattle, his servants, everything attached to him lost their life because of one man's sin. Righteousness exalts a nation. Sin brings a reproach on any people. And this is why America is in trouble. Because we have sinned and we keep sinning and nobody's checking it. And so innocent people have to pay. When judgment is set in on a country, or America, or a family, or a church, or whatever, there's going to be casualties until it's dealt with. And he took them out. And they stoned all of them, and they raised over him a great heap of stones unto this day.
Mm-hmm.
So the Lord turned the fierce of his anger, wherefore the name of that place is called the Valley of Achor unto this day. The favor of the Lord didn't come back. The anointing did not come back until the sin was dealt with. We can no longer jump and shout. We can no longer turn a deaf ear. We that are leaders of anything have a great deal of responsibility. And we're going to have to speak up and speak out. We're going to have to challenge the sin at hand. Sometimes the Lord places us in hostile environments so we can challenge what's really going on in that situation. He uses us in such a way that some people will never understand. because they have wrong motives. They do not care about people losing their life. They do not care about the withdrawal of the anointing. They do not care that a hedge have been taken away from around them because of sin. It's the sin that's doing you in. Mm-hmm. And innocent people have to pay. All these folk that's attached to him lost their life. And they hadn't done nothing. But they was attached to the wrong person. You got to be very careful who you attach yourself to. Mm-hmm. Whose side you decide to get on. Mm-hmm. Because there's consequences.
Oh, yes.
The choices you make, understand they come with consequences. And so Joshua, he lost his right-hand man. Do you not know that's hurting to a leader? To find out the one you really trusted was the one that betrayed you? The one you thought you didn't have to keep your eyes on? The one you just deemed honest? And they were the very one was stealing in the camp. They caused this accused thing to come up on everybody in the camp. Because of one man's sin, God mm-hmm. charged it to Israel. Mm-hmm. And because Joshua was over the tribe, he was the leader. He had the experience lost too. Mm-hmm. Righteousness exalts a nation. Sin brings a reproach on any people. I don't care if you're the chief apostle. I don't care if you're a lay member. I don't care what your position is. You held accountable. That's why the president of the United States of America, he's held accountable. The Bible says, to whom much is given, mm-hmm. much is required.
Amen.
Because he's president of the United States of America. When he make decrees and sign laws, he held accountable. Yes, mm-hmm. other people going to pay. But he going to show enough be held accountable. Because it was on his watch. That's why we have to be led by the Spirit of God. We got to stay in prayer. And don't let nothing drown out his voice. The Lord know the way through the wilderness. Mm-hmm. All we have to do is follow. And we have to be obedient. Mm-hmm. It might cost you Amen. Some crying days. Mm-hmm. It may cost you some staying up all night. Mm-hmm. But until you deal with it, mm-hmm. you stagnated. The church is at a standstill. The movement was at a standstill. They couldn't get no more victories. The Lord challenged the leader, you either deal with this thing or I'll deal with you. Mm-hmm. Either you confront it or I'm taking my hands off you. Mm-hmm. And I don't know how y'all feel about it, but I come too far from where I started from to let any man, woman, boy, or girl cause me to lose my anointing. I worked too hard. I shed too many tears. I've been lied on. I've been walked on. For the gospel's sake. And so I come by to tell you, we have to challenge sin. And sometimes you have to challenge it at the family reunion. Mm-hmm. You got to challenge it in the church. Mm-hmm. Wherever you may be. We have to challenge it. We can no longer. That's why you got to be careful who you let in your house. Mm-hmm. You have to be careful who dates your daughter. You have to really look and see. Try the spirit by the spirit and see if it be of God. It's a great deal of responsibility. At least you can say you told them. If they're going to go error, at least It needs to be put on record that you told them that this thing is not right in the sight of the Lord. Father, I thank you for the word on today.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, I pray that they not only be hearers of the word,
yes,
that they will become doers of the word.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, as a leader of Sunrise, Lord, I repent.
Yes, Lord.
If I hadn't done all that you wanted me to do to check sin at the door.
Yes.
Lord, bless these families, God.
Yes, Lord.
Give them the courage to confront sin.
Yes, Lord.
In the name Jesus. Of Jesus.
Yes,
Lord, we repent for turning a deaf ear.
Yes, Lord.
For turning our heads.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, bring us back.
Yes, Lord.
Where we can confront sin at the door. In the name of Jesus. Lord, don't withdraw yourself from us. Whither shall we go? Let the anointing, God, go before us.
Yes, Lord.
First of all, Lord, show us what a sin lies. Show us, Lord. Sometimes we just don't know. But show us. And then give us the courage to confront it. In the name of Jesus. And God, I pray that this message, God, fall on good ground.
Mm-hmm.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, indeed.
Lord, let accomplish that you set out for it to accomplish.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus, Yeshua. This is my prayer in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray and ask it all. Amen, amen, and thank God.
Amen.
All right. Anybody got any comments before we ship in the offering? If you need, anybody need prayer? Because you know you're guilty. And you want this thing lifted off of you.
Amen.
Sometimes we don't know why things ain't going right for us. Every time we look up, we have different challenges that we're not meeting. We're being defeated in every area of our life. Nothing going right. Maybe perhaps a sin that's going unchecked. I see you, Shorty. I see you.